What's up, guys? Chris here from Mainly Mesh. Today we're going to talk about how to string the perfect pocket. Keep in mind, a lot of this is based on my preference, but also a lot is backed up by the data we had when I had a retail store back at Mainly Mesh and all of the thousands of customer reviews we've had over the years. In addition to the mass production runs that I've done through my time at Epic and with a few other companies. I'm just gonna get right into it. There is a little formula that I like to use when I'm stringing a stick. It is based upon the generic construction of 99% of the meshes out on the market. I will address different constructions in my next video when I talk about meshes like Mesh Dynasty meshes, stuff like that. But this theory is all dependent on the popular style of mesh, which is a 10 diamond hexagon. Yes, hexagon construction. And the formula goes as follows. Pull four down, float one, stack, float three. That's it. Let's talk about the pull four. This right here has a lot to do with the overall shape of your pocket. As you can see right here, I have outlined the tension created by pulling down the first four 10 diamond rows of mesh with a 9 diamond top string. You will see that that fourth diamond is the furthest diamond I can pull that leads directly to the top center of the head. Any extra diamond that I pull, the fifth, the sixth, is going to be pulling down tension below that scoop of the head, which is something I want to avoid. If you guys watched my theory video on the perfect pocket, I want to have the ball be able to travel the most distance possible within this head for the most force distribution. So once I start pulling down any more than four diamonds, I'm pulling, in my opinion, too much tension across this top and I'm losing a bit of extra force and consistency. You'll notice I create this very gradual U profile, and this is not something new. This has been talked about for years. String King has talked about the U versus the V channel, and there have been plenty of diagrams over the years. But in my opinion, I want as much of a U channel as possible because I want the friction from the mesh being driven from the sides, not from at an angle. When I have that V shape, that's when I'm adding more whip to my stick. Whereas versus on the side, I can have a little kinetic friction, a little bit more hold without having the static friction of whip. Sound familiar? I did a bunch of videos on this in my Goldilocks channel theory years ago. If you want to see some awkward Chris at 50 pounds lighter videos, check out my Goldilocks videos. Voice crack and a burp. Also notice how this pull down four takes me almost halfway down the head, okay? That's a good bulk of my pocket right there. Already starting to run out of room. Now for this next one, I'm gonna float. When I say float, a lot of times this is done in my pockets with a knotted SI, as you can see here, but notice how there's a good amount of space between the fourth pull down and this fifth diamond in the stacked SI, right? So I've got a little bit of space here, and that's what I'm defining as my float. The reason I'm calling it a float comes back from the days when this theory originated, where most heads only had about 10 sidewall holes. So I actually wasn't able to put an extra knotted SI in the sticks that I was stringing back then. And so I would have to float by doing essentially a one into a stacked SI. You can still do that these days if you want. I've just tended to lock that down, so I'm kind of spreading out some tension and not having all of the tension run through that stacked SI. It saves the string, saves the mesh a little bit. Now after that float, now I'm putting my stacked SI with the sixth and seventh diamonds of my pattern here. This is where I have a little bit of flexibility. If I wanna shift this pocket a little bit higher, I can move it up a little bit more, but basically I want this stacked SI to sit right about at the lowest point of the bottom rail. Now the Z1 has a very low bottom rail, so I'm not gonna shove that stacked SI all the way down there, but this is about where I want my ball to sit most of the time. As you can see, it is correlated with the most narrow point of the head, like I talked about in my last video. And where that stacked SI is typically gonna be the deepest part of my pocket, where the ball sits the most. But what it also does is it establishes a bit of a sweet spot when I'm shooting at about a 45 degree angle from where that stacked SI is located. So you can see here, I've got my stacked SI. If I push my hand up, that's where that ball is gonna catch the most. It's gonna be at a 45 degree angle. So if I wanted to shift this pocket up a little bit, I could shift this stacked SI one hole higher, and that would create my sweet spot right about here. Notice how that sits pretty high in the head, but the deepest part would still be straight below that stacked SI, which would still be very much so in that narrow point of the head. So the stacked SI allows you to really have the feel of a higher pocket without sacrificing any ball retention. Part of the beauty of the knot. Now from here, I'm gonna float three. As you can see, I'm essentially just doing three ones to finish out the stick. The reason I wanna float these is because there tends to be a lot of movement in the bottom part of the section when you're cradling, and I want those pieces of mesh to move with the ball. I've found that if I do knotted SIs down here, or even at a fourth row, I tend to, in my opinion, lose a bit of ball retention. That's just by feel, could be completely in my head, but I want that mesh to be staying in contact with the ball as much as possible, so I have as much kinetic friction and therefore as much hold as possible. If you like an even baggier pocket, you could add a fourth here, but typically almost all of my pockets are gonna be using 10 diamonds, not 11. Now, if you try this and you're like, this pocket isn't high enough, it doesn't have enough width for me, no, Chris, this is not perfect. The only other rubric I have in my back pocket for those high pocket lovers, it's the same pattern I used way back when we used to string for Paul Rabel. I actually think it's the most goals he scored that year. Don't quote me on that.
Yeah, I just looked it up. I totally made that up. He went off in 2016. I thought he was using our sticks then, but he used them in 2015. Oh, well.
But here's that rubric. Pull down four. You want to maintain that channel, except this time now I'm going to put the stacked SI with the fifth and the sixth. As you can tell, the lowest point of that pocket would be right here, and the sweet spot would be at that 45 degree angle, which you can see would be very high in the pocket. And then I'm just gonna float four at the bottom. The only reason I would prefer this style of rubric is it creates a very kind of boatish feel at the bottom of the head. You end up having to kind of pull some slack out if you really wanna focus it in that spot. And like I mentioned in my video on the theory of the perfect pocket, I just feel like you sacrifice a little bit of ball retention. But if you like that high pocket style, give that a go. You'll probably be pretty happy with it. So that's really it. You got the four pulls, one float, the stack, three floats. You've got your perfect pocket. As far as shooting strings go, the reason you almost always see me use the one nylon, one shooting lace. Do I have? Yeah, there's my Z1. Boom. Shout out to Traddy Tree for painting this bad boy up. Is because the way the tension on this style of pocket works, my release point is just about at the top of the head, and then I have my shooting lace right about where the stacked SI releases. If I put it any lower, it's gonna interfere with that stacked SI and have too much whip in my opinion. I think, and don't quote me on this is still the pattern that Rambo uses. He was using the factory strung for a while, but he adds a third shooting lace there, so it can be done. That would have too much width for me, but he's much better at lacrosse than I am, so take that as you will. And yes, this stick is strung to the inside, but it also follows the same rubric, so we'll address that in a different video. That's it. Will you only ever see me string that pattern? No. Some heads require slightly different stringing technique. Some people require slightly different technique. Also, I get bored, so I try new things, and I try to get the same effect with different knots. I have probably strung this pattern, 15,000 times, 20,000 times. So I like to mix it up. But of the tens of thousands of heads I have strung, I have never strung a pocket with this type of mesh that has been more consistent and more well enjoyed than this rubric. If you guys have any questions, please add them in the comments down below. My next video, I will attack funky meshes like this one. Not sure when that will be, but I appreciate your patience in the meantime. Thanks so much. Stay safe, guys. I will catch you guys next time.